Here's how I made that RTI page. It works for here, works for Vandenberg, Rogers, wherever you go, it'll work. All you need is, which you already had, was the master list from the office of all the kids A to Z. And I put them all into one big gigantic column. I merged the cells together. It's a formula called like Kintikati, or I don't know what it's called, but I can help you with that too. Here they all are, A to Z, from 6th grade to 12th grade. And I also have the teacher for advisory next to it too. So I'm using this as my master list to sort the rest of the document. I also made a page I call staging. It's the very end of the document. Maybe you can't see it on the camera yet. It's just all the teachers' names for advisory, A to Z. So I'm going to reference these and that master list and all my formulas. So I'm on the Davis page right now. Here it is. If I go up here to this box, I wrote the teacher's name in called Davis. It's a formula. I have it equaling a specific cell on the whole page. So I'm equaling the staging page, cell A19. So that again, if you go back to the staging page, it's Davis. I'll show you why I do that in a minute here. And below Davis, here's his roster. How is that flowing automatically? Watch here. In A2, the formula is called equals filter, in a parenthesis. This first thing here is student B2B. So it's searching the students page, column B2B. So it's going to look back at the student page, which is this master list up here. It's going to sort through all these people here. Because that filter is kind of how it works, is this is what I want. I want to return anything in this column. And the condition is, if the student's page A to A, which is the advisory teacher's names, which is the teacher for advisory teacher's names, sorry, there you go. If this column, like the Cooley, Anderson, Kivitz, Swanson, Herman, Yankee, if these equal whatever's in A1, which is in this case Davis. So this should just automatically flowing in. That's the easy part. Over here in B2, it looks blank. There's also another formula in here too. And this is where it'll fill in the same as the other column over here did. It's also an equals filter. This is what you want. This is the condition. Here I want to put in every teacher that picks my students so I know where they're going to go. Same thing. On a return anything in the students column C. So I want to have the teachers' names that pick these kids. In this case, which is column C, if they pick the kids, here they are. So I want to return these names if the condition again, the students on that back page, which is the student list. Here you gotta do it kind of one by one. It's equals A2. So I'm saying if bring the teacher's name from this list, if this name matches that name. So it's specific, so that's certain call, it has to be A2. Here I copy this formula and I pasted it down one for A3, A4, A5, 6, 7, copied and pasted them all down. I filled them all in advance. These are references. These are errors, but no big deal because I need to have every formula set in place. So I built one sheet. I set this formula in advance, that one in advance, that one in advance. Over here now is going to be my roster for RTI, or sorry, Davis's roster. So it's doing the exact same thing. It's saying to equals filter. I want the students' names from that column B to B. If the teacher's name is this Davis. I put dollar signs here, I'm not sure why. Those you don't need. Sorry, remove the dollar signs. So it's the exact same things we did over here. Here I want to have the teacher that picks my kids. So I picked the columns to bring back C, looking at the B column. Here I want to have the kids I pick. So I'm picking the same formula. I want the kids if the teacher's name matches mine. These are my kids. That's all set in advance. Like that there, the filter one, it just you set it once and it'll flow in automatically. But this one's it's kind of name by name specific. You had to have that equals A1, A2, A3, A4. It's just kind of how it works. This is kind of weird. And then this here again, like you had done yours, it's just data validation, absence or tardies. So I built one page in advance. The nice part is, I'm off camera here, but I've got a little tab on the bottom of the screen. I labeled mine tab Davis. I click on the little arrow, and I pick duplicate. Then I have two Davis pages. But I want to have the next page in advance. So watch here. I'm on A19's Davis. If I go equals A20, it'll change the teacher's name. It'll flow in all of the students for free. The page is done. I have to go down to the tab name. It's right now it's called Copy of Davis. I don't want that. I'm going to click the arrow, and pick Rename, and pick Doherty. And that one is done. And if I do the same thing again and again and again for all the staff, it'll be done in no time flat. But spelling counts for tab names. I spelled Doherty's name wrong, sorry. There we go, got it. Why it says here that a reference, my guess is something up here is not going right with the formula. So I'm guessing that this name might be wrong or invalid. I'll figure that out later. What's causing that to happen. So Doherty is done. Because this formula references that page, A20. It flows in his names. There they are. It'll bring back the teachers that pick his kids and flow them in here for him automatically. And over here is the kids that he picks will flow in here too. So Doherty is done. I push the arrow. I'll duplicate Doherty. There it is. Next one's A21. There's Doran, there's his list, he's ready to go. Change the page name. Works for anything you want to do with this chart here. Is it the best way to do it? I don't know. It works pretty slick. And the nice part too is whenever like students will change advisories or change, drop or add, all you got to do to update, rather than updating each individual list for each teacher, back here again, change it here, and it's done. So if kids add, I can add them in, resort it, it'll populate the list for you automatically. And that's about how complicated the RTI thing is. Until we start figuring out how to do attendance. That's the fun part. So I'll kind of do a few more and I'll stop. If you want to kind of keep tinkering, go ahead. But that's the RTI in a nutshell.